She made that, Rachael.
It's so perfect. How are the girls doing? How are they eating? Are they cooking? Tell me everything.
You will be so happy to know some answers to that awesome question. So we're watching a ton of, we love cooking shows, like the Chopped Juniors and the MasterChef Juniors.
Oh, yes, so fun, yes.
Love. And then Olive just made me this, I mean, she just loves cooking. And I now, like, let her. She's going to be 9 almost. And so I'm just like, you know what? Now you go. You run the kitchen. I'm seriously sometimes have to come in and just check the burners and make sure they're all off. But she'll go and make these elaborate breakfasts with like perfect sunny side up eggs and
veggie sausages
and toast. And she made that, Rachael.
It's so perfect.
Eggs.
You know, the reason that there is 101 folds on a chef hat. And I'm not a chef, I'm a cook. The reason there's 101 folds is 101 ways to master eggs, because the most difficult thing to do as a chef is master eggs. And look at your young lady mastering eggs like that. And by the way, I'm 52, and my husband turns off the burners after I'm done in the kitchen all the time. I leave them on all the time. And when I was on Drew's show the very first time, no joke, I can only make this joke because it's about my house. My house had burned down, and I set myself on fire, a string on my shirt, on Drew's show, literally on her show in my kitchen. So I don't care if she leaves the burner on. Those are perfect eggs.
What's also amazing is Olive made this beautifully composed breakfast with these perfect eggs. And then if you walk in her room, she's decided that she is now has opened a spa in her room. So there's a foot bath, there's a wax warmer.
Amazing.
There's sheet masks, but it's like the most pigpen spa you've ever been to. It's disorganized. The hot wax is now on the carpet. The sheet masks are out of the thing and just like dangled, hanging over the trash can, looking like dead fish. The foot spa water has been in there for 3 days. Oh, and she has a snake in her room too. If you just didn't have enough of a weird experience at this odd spa of hers. And she's always like, do you want to come to my spa? And I'm like,
oh, you want God. To come to the spa?
Literally,
what is the snake's name? What's the snake's name?
Spike.
I love it. And I'm so psyched that she is the woman who has a spa that's accessible. She's trying to do what you do, Drew, break down the barriers, make people chill and feel cool to come to the spa.
I'm just so glad that she has an interest and, you know, whatever the interests are, as long as they're not dangerous, I'm like, look, let's foster that. Like, you'll find your rhythm. You'll try a million different things. And, you know, you're into snakes. Okay. You want to like get hot wax on your carpet. Okay.
Okay.
And then all of a sudden I will whip around and turn to her if she doesn't keep herself safe or like, you know,
right.
Doesn't behave around someone. It's like all of a sudden I go from the most loosey-goosey choose my battles mom to, and now I mean it. And now I'm serious.